Right, so this is a new platformer game, 2D platformer that was released in August 21st this year. It only has four reviews as of the time of recording, and first thing I noticed, there's no mouse support, there's no sound effects for the beginning of this. There was no ultimate reveal towards the title screen, which is something. It's very like 16 8-bit, whatever it is. The settings, there's more than three settings. The music and sound effects are separated, so that's something. There's no way for me to test it because there's no sound in the menu, which I find. I guess sound effects does play sound when I look. A better way of telling how loud and quiet that is. Nothing for music though, which seems a bit odd. Settings are just meh, but it's better than a lot of other games like this. So let's check this out. Press A button to, oh fuck, it's got it done by controller support. I'll just unplug the controller so I don't get more of that, because I now don't know the controls. Oh shit, I forgot. So the setting of the game is the number on top of my character's head is the amount of jumps I can do within the level. You only get limited jumps, so I kind of fucked that up. Alright, I'll have to restart. Alright, that's nice. A nice little noise for when I get all the. Okay, that was pretty easy. No tutorials or anything, but. What the fuck? I'm not actually gonna have to do mess, am I? But then the thing's gonna. So I gotta pretty much get rid of all of my jumps to do this. But after my one jump, I can't jump. And jump after I fell? No, I can't. So I have to jump while I'm in air, like when I'm on ground. Damn it, there's no double jumping. There's multiple controls for movement. Alright. No, that's all there is. There's movement and jump. Movement. Oh, you see icon for the game. Right, four jumps. Got a cliff? I can't scroll down, so. Thank you. So this game's looking alright. It's looking very bare bones. Oh, fuck me. And, relatively difficult, but it seems to blend, puzzle and platforming relatively well together, which isn't something that's altogether dumbfounded nowadays. It's not like you can't find that elsewhere, but, it still does it to a well enough extent that I don't feel like I'm outright scammed having purchased this or anything. Yeah, the problem that I have more with this is the fact that it's harder to, it's more on the puzzle than it is the platforming. Okay, I shouldn't have done that. Can't believe you've done this. There's nothing that's gonna, like, blow you away, it seems, this game. But it is something like every other game's meant to do it, just entertain you for a bit. Oh, that was the whole world. Okay, there's not a boss each level, then. I probably won't get the bosses, to be honest. Oh, there's a story. Okay, it's still got the controls input, so, this has, like, 8 or levels to it. Are these guys harmless, or...? It's going at fucking... That was going at 60 FPS, yet it seemed like it was lagging. I thought those spikes would kill me, but I guess... Seeing that last... Oh my god, there is mass. Right, this game can get fucked. seems like harsh reason to hate it, but, you know, fuck it. Not an actual critic, I can... judge this game on whatever the fuck I want. I like the jumps thing though, it's an interesting detail. It's just like, my god, I had no idea how mass heavy this game would be. It's always clunky no matter how it's done. It's not the sort of game that I see a kid learning mass would just enjoy doing and being capable of doing or anything. This is something more an older audience would do. So, them doing mass, I just don't. I don't see this doing that well. Like, the idea of a... Yeah, like, you can just see from my gameplay, like, how a kid wouldn't be capable of doing it. But what? I actually have to get all those keys just to fucking... Okay. There's not even a way up from here. So I'm supposed to just finish with three keys so I can get those last two. I've got to use this jump to get back over. Ah, I see, I see. Guess I'm just a big idiot. It's not the game's fault, you guys. And I can still blame how the puzzles are designed. Like in the puzzles, it would take the whole game for me to really judge all of the puzzles, and I'm just simply not gonna play the entire game. So more of a quality control kind of aspect that I do with these, as anyone that watches should know. To fucking be able to make it to that too. Because the wind's pushing me back, so I stand. What? Maybe the trees are immune. Are immune to the wind. Oh, and this part sends me forward. But okay, so it just swaps over at certain points. What's it? Yeah, it only pushes me back, it seems, when I'm moving, for whatever reason. I'll try this last level, but you know, if I get stuck, I think I can suck my left nut. some Negative World, a free game. You can a new game. You can check it out. How much was this? I think it was like $9 or $5 or something like that. I got it on sale, so it wasn't that much for me. If you like 2D puzzle platformers and you wanted to go harder on the puzzle, it's not even a puzzle, it's just solving the fucking math, really. Well, I guess for mathematicians, I might debate that. So, if you like doing math and platforming, then it's for you. If not, if you wanted more of the 2D platformer, fuck yeah. Hope you all enjoyed.